Hi guys, this is Nilesh from IDZO. Today let's look at Knuth-Morris-Pratt algorithm. This algorithm is used in pattern matching and runs in linear time. Let's look at an example for pattern matching. If we have to search for the pattern 3A's followed by B in the following given text, then as you can observe, the pattern could be found at the very end of the text as highlighted here. Now let's look at an IU approach for the pattern matching. In this approach, what we do is, we keep sliding the pattern across the given text one character at a time, starting from leftmost end of the given text. For example, for this given text and this pattern, we start matching the pattern to text from leftmost end. Now as you can see, all the characters of the pattern except the character B match with the text. And once we see the mismatch, what we do is, we right shift this pattern by one character. Again, all the characters from the pattern except the character B match, and therefore we again right shift this pattern by one character. We keep doing this until the match is found or all the characters from the text are exhausted. So as you can see, at the very end of the text, there is a match for the pattern. Now what would be the time complexity for this method? If you observe carefully, in the worst case, what happens is, except first few and last few characters from the text, each character of this text is matched against all characters of the pattern. Therefore, worst case time complexity for this method would be order of mn, where m is length of the text and n is length of the pattern. Let's now look at a better approach for pattern matching. We'll be basically discussing KMP algorithm. This algorithm runs in linear time, but before execution of main algorithm, it requires computation of LPS array for the pattern which we are going to search. In this LPS array, LPS of I is defined as, for the substring which starts from the index 0 and ends at index I, LPS of I is the length of the longest proper suffix which is also a proper prefix. Let's try to understand this definition using this example. Say we are given this pattern and we want to find out the LPS array for this. If you want to find out LPS of 6, we'll consider substring ABCD ABC because C has index of 6. And now LPS of 6 is 3 because this is a proper suffix and this is a proper prefix. These both are equal and length of it is 3, therefore LPS of 6 would be 3. Similarly, LPS of 5 would be 2 because this suffix AB is equal to this prefix AB. In the same way, LPS of 4 would be 1. For all other remaining substrings, there is no common proper suffix and proper prefix. Therefore, LPS of remaining elements is 0. Hopefully, the definition of LPS is clear now. The computation for this LPS array also takes linear time. You can watch my previous video here, which covers this LPS computation part. With LPS computation being complete, let's now look at the main KMP algorithm. We'll try to understand this KMP algorithm using couple of examples. Say we have to find this pattern ABCD ABCY in the given text. Then as usual, we start matching the pattern to text from leftmost end. As we go on matching the characters from the pattern, you can see that all the characters would match except the last character Y. So all the characters from the pattern have matched except the last character. Now recall that in the naive approach, what we would do is, we would shift the pattern by one character to the right. That would get us into this state, where this A is now compared to this B of text. Let's come back to this state where Y mismatched with X. Now what we know is, all the characters before this Y have matched with the text. That also implies that the last 6 characters before Y have matched with text, right? So notice that for substring ABCD ABC, last 6 characters have matched with this portion of the text. And now what we are trying to do is, we are trying to match first 6 characters of ABCD ABC with the same portion of the text that match with last 6 characters. And we know that last 6 characters, that is BCD ABC, are not equal to first 6 characters. Therefore, right shifting this pattern by one character is always going to result in mismatch. In other words, for string ABCD ABC, length of longest proper suffix, that is also a proper prefix, is not 6. Length of longest proper suffix, that is also a proper prefix, is not 6. Therefore, shifting by one character is always going to result in mismatch. Let's try to understand this concept using another example. Here again, all the characters of the pattern before character Y have matched with the text. Now after the mismatch, if we right shift this pattern by one character, we will reach this state. Coming back to the initial state where Y mismatched with character X. Notice that these 6 characters matched with this portion of the text. And by shifting the pattern by one character, what we are trying to do is, we are trying to match the same portion of the text with first 6 characters. Here there is a match between first 6 characters and this portion of the text because last 6 characters of the substring are equal to first 6 characters. The substring we are considering is substring formed by first 7 A's. In other words, for this particular substring formed by 7 A's, length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix is 6, and therefore shifting by one character has helped here. Let's come back to the original example. What we have concluded is, we first look at the substring just before the mismatch, that is ABCDABC, and because for that substring, length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix is not 6, therefore it does not make sense to right shift the pattern by one character. Similarly, for the same substring, observe that if we right shift this pattern by two characters, we will reach this state, and this portion is matched against last 5 characters CDABC, and the same portion is now being matched against first 5 characters, and last 5 characters are not equal to first 5 characters. Or for this substring, length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix is not 5. Therefore, it does not make sense to right shift the pattern by two characters as well. Using the same logic, you can observe that right shifting this pattern by three characters also does not help, because this portion ABCD, this portion ABCD is not equal to this portion DABC. This DABC is matched against this portion, right? So shifting by three characters also did not help. Let's see what happens if we shift the pattern by four characters. Now note that these three characters have matched with this portion of the text. Why is that? Because this portion ABC, which matched with this portion, is same as first three characters ABC, right? Or in other words, for substring ABCDABC that we obtained by looking at the substring just before the mismatch, length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix is 3. Therefore, right shifting the pattern by 4 has helped in this case. Let's look at this portion more carefully. For substring ABCDABC, last 3 characters were equal to first 3 characters. Therefore, shifting the pattern by 4 has helped in this case. Now, if you observe more carefully, notice that these 3 characters are equal to these 3 characters, and this portion has already matched with this portion of the text. Therefore, we can actually skip matching these 3 characters because we know that they are anyway going to match, and we can actually start matching from the 4th character of the pattern. So if length of longest proper suffix for ABCD ABC that is also a proper prefix is 3, then we can skip matching first 3 characters because they are anyway going to match, and directly start matching from the 4th character to mismatch character in text. So 4th character in the pattern would be D, and mismatch character in the text would be X. So we start matching D to X and skip matching these 3 characters. We can actually generalize this statement and say that for the match substring, in this case that was ABCD ABC, if length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix is K, in this case K was 3, then we can skip matching first K characters. Then we can skip matching first 3 characters and then directly start matching character starting at kth index, because indexing scheme starts from 0. Now using this rule, let's continue searching for the pattern in the given text. We match D with X, we see that there is a mismatch. Now match substring would be ABC, and for this string ABC, we again find out the length of longest proper suffix that is also a proper prefix. In this case that is 0, therefore we cannot skip matching any characters, or we start matching first character that is at index 0, that would be A, to the mismatched character, that would be X. So we start matching A to X. Here again, we see that there is a mismatch. Now in this case, the character from the pattern that mismatched is at index 0. We cannot skip matching any characters and we just right shift the pattern by one character. Now in this state of the algorithm, substring AB from the pattern matches with the text, but the character C does not match with X. We again look at the substring that match, in this case that is AB, and for AB, length of the longest suffix, which is also prefix, is 0. Therefore, we cannot skip matching any characters and start matching first character that would be at index 0 to the mismatched character. Mismatched character would be X again. So we match A against X, we see that there is a mismatch, and because A is at index 0 in the pattern, we just right shift the pattern by one character. Now in this state of the algorithm, all the characters from the pattern match to text except the last character Y. We again look at the substring that match with the text, that would be ABCDABC, and find out the length of the longest suffix, that is also prefix for this substring. The length is 3 in our case because ABC is equal to ABC, and therefore we can skip matching first 3 characters and start matching 4th character, that would be at index 3, 4th character is D, and start matching this character to the mismatched character. Mismatched character is D again. So we start matching D from the pattern to D from the text. In this state of the algorithm, you can see that all the characters from the pattern have matched with the text. Now before looking into the code, let's just recap what we have discussed till this point. The first part of the KMP algorithm is to find out the LPS array, which basically indicates the length of the longest proper suffix, that is also a proper prefix, for each substring from 0 to I for all possible values of I, right? And in the second part of this algorithm, what we do is, we look at the substring of the pattern that has matched with the text just before the first mismatch. So in that case, that was substring ABCDABC. And for this substring, we find out the LPS value. LPS value for this would be 3. Therefore, we pick the character at third index, that would be D, and start matching with mismatched character from the text. This is rule number 1, and rule number 2 is, if the character at 0th index from the pattern mismatched with the text, then in that case, we just right shift the pattern by one character. I hope the algorithm explanation was clear. Thank you and cheers.